So the first step you need to take when you are using this spacer kit to install the Turatec upper and lower crash bars, or just one or the other, while you are also using the valve cover guards, is to grab this laser cut spacer pack and a pair of pliers and just start breaking all these pieces off. All these tiny little cross pieces are just going to go in the garbage or the recycle, but the circles and then this big oblong shape you're going to need. So once you got these cut apart, you should have three little circles, one big circle, and then the one oblong shape piece. This is for the upper crash bars where the two side bars meet with the center crossbar. You're gonna need the spacer there. This is for the lower crash bar where the large Delrin puck is in the upper rear position. And then these two go on the lower mounting points for the lower crash bar. And this one goes in the shared mounting point that's at the top of the lower crash bar and the bottom of the upper crash bar. Otherwise, the installation goes exactly the same as they normally do. Turatec does provide a few longer bolts to accommodate the extra length of these spacers. So, won't be much talking. I'll just go to putting it all back together. So the installation on the bike is exactly the same with or without this valve cover guard installed. The only difference is where you install these spacers and what bolts you use. So I'm not going to go into a lot of detail about how you install the crash bars. I'm just going to outline where the spacers go, and you guys can just watch it get assembled here pretty quick. So on the throttle hand side of the motorcycle, we're going to install one of the spacers here in between the Delrin and the stainless steel. On the clutch lever side of the motorcycle, you have to actually change the bolt out for a longer one. But here on the throttle side, you can see there's a ton of extra threads there, so no need on this side. For the circular spacers, there are small diameter ones and a large diameter one. You want to make sure that you use the large diameter one in this position because it fits nicely up against the back of the spacer. Remember to leave this bolt loose enough that you can still move it around so you can get the crash bars located perfectly on the bike. So with the three smaller circular spacers, you'll see that two of them have a larger diameter hole than the third one does. So with the lower two bolts here on the crash bars, here and here, you want to make sure you use the two with the larger diameter holes. Okay, so the lower crash bar is installed loosely at this point. We've got the two bottom bolts in loose. We have the upper rear bolt in with the Delrin spacer, and we've left the forward mounting hole open. That's because we still have to mount the upper crash bar. So we'll grab that now. With the upper crash bar, we are gonna reuse most of the bolts. So we have these two bolts here from the upper mounting position. Those we reuse exactly the same, and we install this spacer in between the crash bar and the crossbar up at the front there. At the rear mounting point right here, we are going to use the longer M8 bolt that came in the spacer kit, and we'll make sure that we install the small diameter spacer with the M8 hole in this lower mounting position. It goes behind the lower crash bar, and then the upper crash bar goes on top of that. So we're going to use the longer bolt from the spacer kit to replace this slightly shorter bolt from the upper crash bar kit. Make sure that you put anti-seize on this bolt since it's got a nylock nut going onto it. All right, now this one's kind of fiddly to see, but we're going to get this spacer behind or in between the lower crash bar and the white piece of the frame. And then this bolt goes through the upper crash bar and the lower crash bar and the spacer. Then you just put the washer and the nylock nut on the backside. And that's it. So I recommend keeping everything loose until you've installed both sides on the motorcycle. And then you can start by tightening up the bolts at the bottom, work your way up to the top, and then do the Delrin spacers at the back last. Other than that, it's pretty straightforward, really easy. And we're going to finish this bike up and get her out on the road. Thanks for watching.